All right, on this note, with the screens in the backdrop, we're going to take a camera right now. Take a look at this fellow who's sitting in the studio right now. And tell me if you know, not the guy on the right, the guy on the left. That is our very own Rico Petrocelli, who is so gracious to be with us here this morning. And Jason, I'm going to let you take it away for a minute or two.
All right, Tom, thanks. As you mentioned, thanks for coming in, Rico. Red Sox legend and now a fan for a long time, I bet. Just
that's right.
You know, give us your thoughts on, you know, maybe from an insider and outsider perspective of this organization and this team this year.
Well, from an insider, having played for the Red Sox, I really give this ownership a lot of credit. You know, they went out and got the ball players when you needed them, the Schillings and the folks in 2004, and now putting this team together and the attitude that they have, it's been tremendous. And they're fan-friendly. Look what they did to Fenway Park. My goodness gracious. Right. Great job. So, you know, from that perspective, I'm really happy for them, for the players, and mostly for the fans. And the big thing this year with this team, and I'll say it, I was just on radio, too, in an interview, is that this team changed when the bombing occurred, after the bombing occurred. This team came together, and they wanted to do something for Boston. And they really put their minds on this winning for the fans, for the people who were killed, the people who were hurt. And they went all the way. It was amazing. Every single day they focused on winning ball games because they knew how important it was to get the city back together. Boston strong. I mean, that's true.
And nowadays, we were talking about this earlier, you know, the job that Ben Cherington did last summer when they traded away all those big-name players and all of that money. I mean, what were you thinking at that time?
I thought they were drunk. Somebody was drinking too much. No, then when you, after a while, when you got to think about it, you know, it wasn't too bad an idea because they weren't going very far. And they did allow them to have some more money to spend. Right. And what they did, they made good choices, the character type guys that we always talk about, and this team put it together.
Now, a lot has changed since you were with the Red Sox from 63 to 76, is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
A lot has changed. I mean, obviously there's more money, free agency, and all that type of stuff has changed a bit, but from a team building perspective, you just kind of touched on it. You want the winning guys and not necessarily the big name guys. Is that right?
Well, that's true. I mean, if you got the big name guys, the guys who really produce, that's great. I mean, you know, like Big Poppy is a great example. But I think teams are looking for character guys, guys that are good on-base percentage, great for the team, will help their teammates. But you do need talent also. I mean, let's face it. You know, there's not that many players around, that caliber of player, you know, often on the field. So it's tough. And that's why they're bidding for players. Players are in a good shape to make a lot of money these upcoming years, I tell you. But I don't begrudge them because that's the market.
Now, what do you think about the Red Sox? That's one of the teams. I think the Blue Jays do a nice job with it. The Red Sox definitely. The Yankees, too, in the AL East anyway, with their farm system. And I know Ben Cherington had a lot to do with that as he kind of climbed the ladder to the GM position. Mm-hmm. But guys like Xander Bogaerts, who, you know, a rookie, and he started in the World Series.
It's incredible, boy. Yeah. He is looks like he's going to be a real good one. Not just his attitude, because you think he was been around, you know, for 10 years. A lot of poise, but he can play. That's right. The main thing. I mean, he makes contact. I mean, there was some pitchers throwing 99 miles an hour. You know, it's a little tough to get around, tough to see. But he looks like he's going to be a good one. The question is he a shortstop or is he a third baseman?
Right.
To me, he looks like a third baseman now. His size and the way he looks like he's going to hit the ball with some power.
Right. Yeah.
But either way, you got. Looks like you got a nice future with him.
Yeah, they definitely get to bring a lot of guys up like Dustin Pedroia and the mix. Let's go back over to Tom now, where.